Okay, let's get into this. Just move that there. All right, so we'll turn that off, bring that up, zoom in a bit. So I'm going to be making a text editor for the terminal. I've used Vim a little bit and I liked it, and I'm going to attempt to replicate that in my own text editor. It's probably not going to be a production ready one, but it's a great way to learn something. I think I found a tutorial online how to set up the terminal for like displaying the text correctly and stuff like that. So I'll be following that and seeing how we go. That internet connection. Good old Australian internet. So I got it here. I do know some of this stuff, like the terminal OS struct and stuff like that. And I'm just going through this. I'll change a few bits and pieces of it. And it's more of a guide, and it explains what things do in the background, because you find some things on Stack Overflow and online in general and forums, and they don't really explain what things do. This actually goes through and tells you what everything you do does. So it's going to be interesting. I've also looked at a bit of the Vim source code. It seems that it does this in the background. It's hard to read for me because there's a lot of if not defined, then do this, and it jumps all over the place. But I have looked at it, how they deal with the terminal and the console, and it's pretty much how they do it. I think you can compile it with whatever this is fucking called, I forget. Sigwin? Yeah, we'll go Sigwin. Sounds about right. That's what I'll be using to compile it. I made a make file. Shrink this down, actually. I'll move that over to the second window so we can see. I'll make it a little bit bigger so I can fucking read it. Desktop space. Don't need that. That'll be alright. There we go. Zoom in. There we go. Alright. Got that all set up. I did make a make file. That was a test stream that I did. Just to make sure I could stream. Quality's not too crash hot, but there's nothing I can do about that, just mainly because of my shitty internet connection, you know, Australian internet. I actually learned a bit about makefiles while I did this. That's one of the reasons I wanted to do this project, just so I could learn about makefiles. We can close it now. So let's get started. I think I've just got a basic Hello World program. That's about it. That's all I got. And that's where I'm going to start. So the first thing we need to do is be able to get input from the keyboard or pretty much anything. So what I'm going to do is use the read system call, Linux system call, and read from the standard input stream, which is a file descriptor, and I think it's number one. Oh no, number zero. I need to do something about the cord for my mic. I think I'm going to end up pulling the fucker out. So we'll include this header, and that will give us access to read, I do believe. Now, the problem with read is that while we haven't set up any more of the, I'll just call that input, while we haven't set up any of the other part of the terminal, it will just wait for us to hit enter, which is fine, I suppose, for now. So we call read, pass in the file descriptor that we want, and this is the variable where it's going to store it. That's not what we wanted. Like that. And then the one is how many bytes we're going to read in at a time. So we're only going to read in one byte at a time, which is a char. Oh, excuse me. And that will let us read that in. Yeah, so by default, your terminal starts in cooked mode, we'll just call it. In this mode, the keyboard input is only sent to your program when the user presses enter, which we will be disabling later. When we run this, if we just save that, make the executable prints hello world, we can just type things out, and then if we press control D, which is a end of line or end of file, so we're actually passing end of file into read, and so it thinks it's the end of the file and that's why it quits out. So now we can actually write. I can't remember the syntax for write. I think it's the same. Out. Let's have a look. Doesn't tell you what it needs. I'll just have to Google it, I think. Nope. that's not right. Let's see. C system call. Yeah, right stream. Yeah, okay. So we'll just outright input, which is the number of characters. The input, what we want to display, and then we the number of bytes, I do believe. Enter. And that's right. Run this. Oh, that's right. Q. There we go. That should be like that. So now we're writing out what we want. All right, so we'll just quit out, clear that. Now we can do this. Input does not equal Q. So now we'll quit out when we enter a queue. So we can just make that again. Now we can type. Now the problem with this is, if we go like that and then put a queue, then do other things, it's going to get cut off where the queue is. And then the rest of it's going to get fed into the terminal, which isn't ideal. So, yeah, we can turn off echoing, which I will do. We'll just make a temporary function init terminal. Doesn't get any input. We're going to have a global so that's raw. We want to include, actually I don't need struct here, do I? This isn't close that off. We should be able to just do that. Save. I will eventually refactor this. This is just to get started. So what we will do is call this, and this will get our current terminal information. And we'll pass the address of save, which we will use to restore the console back to where it was, or the terminal back to where it was when we originally called this. So we're saving the state, and then when we exit out of the application, we're going to reinitialize the original terminal, so we're not changing the user's terminal. And fucking it up, basically. So we're raw. Now this will disable echoing in the terminal, so nothing will be displayed unless we ask it to. to push our changes. All right, so the I think the only thing I need to explain here is the T should be an S, and that should be an A. That there, TCSA flush, basically writes any pending output to the terminal window and discards any input that hasn't been read yet, which is helpful. And this CL flag is a local flag. And obviously echo is a bit mask or bit flag. And we're bitwising not onto this. So we're unsetting the flag basically in the terminal window. And now we need to restore the terminal, which is pretty easy. We'll just restore. I'll do it for now. And enter, bastard. Now we need to pass in basically the same stuff again, and but we need to pass in our saved terminal this time. What we could, we don't need that to be global. We can just make that a local variable because we don't edit it outside of here for now. So that'll be, you can just go in there. Now we need to call. Just gonna get rid of that. We need to call init terminal. And then down here before we return, restore terminal. And now we shouldn't print out anything that's not useful. No, not useful. We shouldn't print out anything unless we do it right. Call it. I think it's printed. There we go. So I can type away and it only prints out after I type things, which is handy. And we quit. Clear. All right, so that's done. We should also set at exit. So we can call that in here, and that will just call a function where we exit. think we can. Can we do that? Yeah, I didn't think so. Have to change how these are defined down to here. Like so. That should work. No. Invalid use of void expression. What? That doesn't seem right. That should work. I had this work the other day. I tested it. I really did. Can we get something here? Yeah. Register a function to run at process termination. Void func. Yeah, that's right. Oh, I might have to. Never mind, because it's a C thing. You what? Oh. You're a nincompoop, mate. You don't need to have them there. They're just passing the function. Pointer. You numbskull. Oh, what? Oh. Off to a great start, ladies and gentlemen. Flying start. Make huh. All right, so we're working. Quit. Sweet. Clear that out. Don't know if that at exit works if the program crashes. Though it could be that it's telling the operating system where to find the function in memory. I'm just guessing. I could be wrong. It hasn't been known to happen. We need to turn off the. God, what the? I can't even read that one. Cook mode. Call it cooked. It's where you have to eat dinner. It's cooked mode because it's on fire. Alright. So we need to. Or, basically, all we need to do is. Or. This under there, and that should be it. So click make that. There we go. And type away. Oh, look, text editor done. As soon as you press Q, it quit it. Very nice. My own key crosses. Now we want to display. The keys that we press a different way, just so we can. Closer. There's a file added here, and I don't know what it is. We'll just have a quick look. C type pedophiles with several functions used for testing and mapping characters. All the functions except int, accept int as a parameter. The values must be end of file or representative as an unsigned char. All functions return non-zero if true. If the argument C satisfies the condition as described, and zero false if not. Okay, the function should be the I did not know these functions existed. Oh, that's a lie. I did know two lower and two upper existed. Is control. That's the one we want. So many frames. Dropping all the frames. Oh, it's cheating, isn't it? I might have to decrease the bitrate a bit more. Decrease the audio a bit. But what can you do? Alright, so we need this. I'm not even going to type it out because I couldn't be bothered. We need this, and we don't need that because we use right. They use printf. I'm just going to use right because I had problems with printf, but we will be using sprintf. And that will let us format the string. Yes. Activate the terminal. Just piss this off. And then we set it so we can restore the terminal. So it's just a global at the moment. I'll move these. I'm going to use C++ for this if you haven't already guessed. So I will eventually move like all the terminal stuff into a class. This restore terminal will have to be a static function so we can pass it to add exit, otherwise it doesn't know where to look. That doesn't matter, I don't think. All right, so we want to check is it a control? So is it a control character? And if it is, do this, else just do this. All right. So is printf, what do you need to be useful? You need a buffer. And that's it. So we can just Number of characters in a char, so 3, 4. So that should be 4. How do we pass in the buffer? Yeah, pass in the buffer, then the string, then the variables. So buff. Now the string. So we're going to display the actual characters of the input when it's a control character. It's like enter, and then we can just call this. Change that to 4. Don't want to input anything, and you just want to output buff. And we'll do the same down here, but it's going to be a bit larger. So we got that. So we'll display the number and the space. That's 3, 4, 5, 6. Then we'll display the character. 6, 7, 8. I'll just give it 10. I think that should be enough. And that should be fine. I'm pretty sure sprintf outputs a null terminated string. Terminating null is, yes, it does. So we won't go over that. So we could make it 20. This should be fine, I think. Just call make. Oh, we had an error. Expecting a derp. So we'll just, there we go. Perils of copy and paste, people. So now, yeah, we can see the characters we type and what their actual value is. Find enters 10. Now if we go press Control A, we get a 1. Control V, 22. We get an 8. 25. Magical. Now the interesting thing is you do a Control J, you get a 10, which is new line. Who knew? Alright. Oh no, we can't Control D. We can Control C though. That's sort of the sucker out. Oh, we could have quit too. It doesn't matter. No ASCII table. It's very. Although, actually, does escape work? I have had problems with that before. Oh, it does work. Alright, I'm getting distracted. Oh. I need to cue your bum. Oh, this is an interesting one. I forgot about these. You can press page up. Bam! That's what page up looks like. That's what your computer gets told. I have tried reading in an integer. To get all of these in one big go, but it doesn't like it at all. Let me do that. Alright. We're gonna have to disable Control S, which is a it basically freezes the terminal so you can like read stuff, or stop sending you output. It's back from the day, I think. We can. We're also going to have to disable Control Z, which suspends the program, which we don't want to do. I think I'm going to leave Control C on. For now. Although I don't think I have a choice. Might leave, yeah, I'll just leave Control C and Control Z on for now. It's pretty easy. So let's just look up. Let's look up this. Here we go. Local modes. We can look at where is it? Input modes. New. We do need to turn off one of these flags, which is that one. We will turn that off. That will disable Control S. And Control Q. And there is another thing we need to turn off. I'm looking for it. We don't need that. Yeah, we don't need that. No. Control modes. Oh, nope. Oh, here we go. This is what I want. Local modes. So we. Local. Echo kill. Echo kill. I don't even know what that does. No, we want. Yeah, so we can just outright disable signals. Don't know how I feel about that. What do they do? It's Control Q, no. Control Z. Suspends the program. I'll probably just leave that. Just because it's not really hurting anyone. And I don't like taking control from the user. So I think we should be okay. I might later on, as we get further on in the configuration file, have it set just so you know, depending on if you want to have it disabled or not, depends on whether or not it gets called. That way, it's up to the user whether or not they want it on or off. I think that'd be the way to go. I think I just found the wasp nest. It's in my roof. I can hear it going. Little bastards. All right. So we'll leave the And if I leave that on as well, if I leave the control C on, if I can't quit out because I've messed up a control somewhere, we can just call, we can just set the signal to quit out. So I think I will leave that on for now. We will have to disable the scroll flag. So we'll come back up here. And it is in, what was it in? Input modes, and it was here. Drag that over here for a second. Copy and paste that. Get rid of these. And change that to that. We'll go back up. And it was a input mode. So we want CI flag, which is easy. And there we go. So Control S should work properly now. Alright, I'm going to have a quick break. And when I come back, we'll keep going, I think. There's a few more things we need to do. Now, Control V. All right, I'll read that in a minute. All right, I'll be back. calm down, mate. Come on. Oh. Jesus. They don't like me in here. I have to get a bug guy. Come and take him out, I think. Right. So, I'm going to drink. We want now, we need to disable control V. So it's control V isn't on all systems apparently, and control V waits for you to type other control sequences. So you hit control V, you'll be able to hit control C. We don't want that, do we? So we add, where is it there? Enable extended input character processing. So we will disable that, so it's another OR. All these all together. Exton. Control M. So if we hit the 13th character of the alphabet, which I can't remember what it is. Oh, shit. L M N O P. That's all we need. So we'll just. So that's one. So we'll go to M. It should be character return. Now let's just start this up and have a look. Basically, what it's doing is it is translating the carriage's returns, like the inputs from like control M and control J, as like what are they called? Like slash N, which is new line. I can't control commands. I think they're called. So we will disable that. So we'll go back in the main. and an eye flag. So ignore carriage return. Is it? No. That one. So we want to turn off. That goes in there. That should turn that off. I will comment all this. And I think we're going to turn that off because otherwise we can't write in I think. I would like to be able to type carriage return, so that's a thing. This is where I've gotten stuck. Wrong button. How do you display carriage return and not carriage return your line, but also recognize when you read the file? I think if you're reading the file, if it's right at the end, it would be recognized as a new line because it will always be at the end. So you can just ignore that, or not ignore it, use it. Pass the string, read to the end, read the last character in the string, and then use that as the control command. Say, new line here. So we'll just save that. I'm going to have to open another one of these terminals, I think. That's not right. They should be not giving 10. What did I do wrong? Outpost. Oh, you numbskull. Copy and paste, people. Copy, paste. Mark of a good programmer. Something's going funny on here. Oh, I got that the wrong way. Try that again. Just do a quick clear. Oh, there we go. It's better. J still gives 10. Alright, that's fine. Quit out. Alright. It's because we're not... It's because we are not doing a carriage return. So if I put a slash R there, we should now move correctly. Yeah, there we go. Oh, control enter equals 30 apparently. Don't know what that does. Sounds fun. Alright. Now. Have a look. I think I'll just leave that as it is for now. Susan, why would you use the Windows version? Start off a few more flags. Alright. In flag, input flag, signal interrupt on break. IPCK. What do you do? Enable input. Whoa. Apparently not really used. Let's have a look. Control. Probably already set like that. We'll handle that in a minute. So we'll just set some more flags, then we'll eventually have to, I'm not going to worry about the breaking int, I don't think, because I don't really need it at the moment. What does iStrip do? Probably already turned off. So that strips the 8th bit of each input character to be set to 0. And CS8 sets it so that input characters are 8 bits, which is 1 byte. Look. Die. That's a bit brutal. We'll deal with that in a minute. All right. That's just some basic error handling. And then he breaks up the code, which I will do. So I think I'll just I'll do this, and I think I might stop streaming. Just getting a bit of a sore back sitting in my chair for so long, getting old. So what do we want? We want to put in. What was it? I don't know what that is. It's a break condition. Normally, receiver transmit data signal stays in the mark voltage until the new character is transformed. Holy shit! What the fuck? What am I reading? I think this is like old school. Are these like old school terminals? Holy Jesus. Oh, wow. That was like used in modems and stuff. That's. Oh. I might put that in. Just cause. Why not? If it breaks stuff, I'll just take it out. I've got nothing to lose. Oh, we might actually need that. Actually, I might. I'll just leave that out for a moment. Can't spell additional extra because I can spell that. One we don't need is this one. We'll throw this one in just. And that's where it goes. Yep. And we will throw in this one. Now we will set, just to make sure we are in 8-bit input. And all right, so I have to set up timeout for read as well. I'm going for a bloody CCT control characters. Down at the bottom. Line control? No. No. Huh. Might be. Is this it? No. Where is it? Output modes. No. Well, I want to see what's in the CCT. Let's have a look. Oh, here it is. Hup da dup dup dup. Not very useful. So that's what we're going to set. Around with that later, I think. Alright, let's throw in some comments just before I go, I think. So here, what do we do? Turn off echo, pretty common. Enable single input and oh geez Louise, probably cheese. So here we enable control plus M and enter. Oh, it's not 8-byte, it's 8-bit. Input. What are you? Tickle me and shit. There, disables control plus C. Oh. I got a phone call. I'll be back. Hello? Okay, back. It was kind of important, so I had to take that phone call. I'm not going to be bothered writing them comments. I know what it does. I think that will do. I'm getting tired, actually. I want to have a nap. Quick nap, power nap, you reckon? Yeah, I'll do. I'll fix this up later, I think. I think that's it. We just need to do some error checking and set read to timeout so the program can do other things like draw in the background. That's about it, I think. Anyway, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.